I'm Chuck Hanson. Welcome to another Holley Tech segment. And today we're going to talk about blowers. That's right, those creators of artificial atmosphere and horsepower. Now, today I've got Shane Weckerly, the director of product management for Weiand Blowers. And, well, he's going to take us to school a little bit on these things. Welcome, Shane.
How you doing, Chuck?
Real good. Now, I've had blowers before, and I know what a powerful addition they are. But, you know, a lot goes into, I'm sure, you know, deciding which one is right for your particular application. Take us through that.
That's certainly true, Chuck. You know, there's a lot of things to consider when you're looking at putting a blower on your car. You know, one of the key things is what do you want to use your car for? Mm-hmm. Is it a drag racing car? Is it a street cruiser? Is it a fairgrounds cruiser where you just want to have a really good image and show off? You know, what do you want to use the car for? That's really the first consideration. You know, once you've made that selection of what you want to do with the car, then you got to decide, you know, what kind of hood clearance do you want? Do you want the 671, 871, where you got carbs and a scoop sticking out of the hood? Or do you want a more conventional, lower profile that you may be under to maybe able to sneak under a 2-inch cowl hood or something
mm-hmm.
like that?
Mm-hmm.
Those are kind of the two starting points for choosing a blower.
Well, now, I like the stealth look myself. I believe in, you know, walking softly and carrying a big stick. And for me, I kind of like the, you know, the blower that stays under the hood.
Right. That's a good choice. The small blowers are real popular. They fit under a lot of muscle car hoods with a small cowl on them, and you know, they do give you that stealthy look, but the performance when you mash that pedal that they just rip down the road.
Mm-hmm.
You know, our smallest blowers come in a 142, 144 size up to a 250, 256 size. That size relates to the size of the actual cubic inch of the blower, how much air it puts out per revolution. If it's a 144, it puts out 144 cubic inches of air for every revolution of the blower.
I see.
And that kind of gives you an idea of how big the blower is.
Mm-hmm.
The you know, when you're selecting that blower, like a small blower for your car, what you're going to see is that the small blowers have more lower RPM potential than the big blowers do. The big blower is going to make a lot more boost upstairs.
Sure.
They're going to be more efficient when you get into those high RPM ranges. But the little blowers are very efficient because they spin fast. They make boost right off of idle, and they're really strong, you know, up into that 5-6,000 RPM range.
Mm-hmm. Now, is it possible to take a 200 plus cubic inch small blower and put it on a smaller motor? Well, you know, say a small block, 355 cubic inch small block, and can you put a blower on it that was intended originally for, say, a big block application?
You can. You know, you really want to match your supercharger to the size of the engine.
Good advice.
If you want a nice mild blower, you're looking at 5 or 6 psi of boost.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you want to stay in the 142, 144. Range for a small block, maybe the 177, 250 range for the big blocks.
So you mentioned 5-6 psi of boost. You go over that, what kind of problems are you going to encounter then?
Well, you're going to run into problems with getting good enough gas. You're either going to have to run race gas, you're going to have to retard the timing a lot, you know, you're going to have to lower the compression when you build the motor anyways.
Sure, sure.
But, you know, unless you're going to run an alcohol injection system or something along those lines, you're going to have to stay under 5-6 psi with a root-style blower on the street.
Well, now, you mentioned, you know, the right engine combination, lowered compression ratio, probably the right camshaft design. What kind of a camshaft are we looking for?
Well, you want to select your camshaft accordingly. There again, it's all about what your selection criteria is going to
mm-hmm.
be. Are you going to race the car? Are you going to have it as a street car? You're going to want to change your overlap depending on whether, you know, it is going to be a low RPM street motor, or
mm-hmm.
you're looking for that peak power.
Mm-hmm.
Really, the best advice I can say on choosing a camshaft is, you know, to call in to the experts and get a recommendation.
Well, there's some good advice. Always call in the experts if you're in doubt.
That's correct.
Now, another thing, you know, and I don't know whether this is true or not, but, you know, a lot of guys say, man, if you're going to run a blower, you got to have forged pistons. True?
It really depends. I highly recommend forged pistons, but there are a lot of good crate motors out with a nice hyper-eutectic piston
mm-hmm.
in them. If you can get one with the 8.5 or 9-to-1 compression ratio,
mm-hmm.
You know, that'll make a good, mild street blower engine. You're not going to want to run that too hard at the drag strip, but for all-around street car, you know, I would recommend that would be acceptable. acceptable.
Great, great. Now, let's talk about this big boy over here.
Okay.
Obviously, a lot more capacity.
Absolutely.
A lot more power potential.
Correct. The the 671, 871 is really Weiand's traditional staple in the blower line.
Mm-hmm.
They've been around a long time. Weiand introduced its first kit in like 1963 for the Chrysler Hemis, and they've just been well accepted and widely popular for years. They make great low end torque and horsepower, but boy, they've just got a killer top end on them that you can't beat.
And they look really impressive. Now, looking at the two, what I notice, looking down through the carb inlet here, I notice the smaller one has straight rotors, lobes.
That's correct.
This one has a helix angle on the rotors and three lobes per rotor.
That's correct. We use a variety of different configurations in our blowers. All of our small blowers have the two-lobe configuration.
Mm-hmm.
The two-lobe configuration, number one, is very good for producing a lot of low-end boost, which is what you want on a small
mm-hmm.
street blower.
Yep.
They give up a little bit of high RPM efficiency, and that's when you get into the 871s that have the three-lobe. When you really want to race the motor and you want all that you can get out of the blower, step up to a three-lobe, and that's going to move your RPM potential up in the RPM band.
Okay. Now, I've also heard people talk about Teflon strips on the lobes of the rotors to seal better the case. I noticed these don't have it.
That's correct, and that's really just an effect from deciding what you want to use the application for. Teflon strips we use on some of our smaller street blowers to help increase that low RPM potential.
Mm-hmm.
The 671s and 871s that Weiand produces do not have that. We predominantly reserve that for race type applications on the 6 and 871s.
Is there sort of a generalization that you can say about choosing a small one as opposed to a big one? I know you mentioned what do you really want to do with it? Do you want the looks? Do you want the stealth look? Do you want more upper end performance? Is there sort of a generalized thing that we can share with everybody who's watching here today to kind of say, okay, that's the one I need?
Right. I think the big thing is really deciding what you want to do with the car for hood height and appearance. Either blower will work in most applications. If you don't want to see the carb sticking through the hood, you don't want that big scoop, then I recommend you go with the smaller blower, especially for a street type application.
Mm-hmm.
If you're like me and you got a car that you want to cruise the fairgrounds with and you want to show off and you want to make a lot of noise, then I highly recommend this because it's a killer combination.
Well, I'll tell you what, I've learned a lot here today. I've owned both types of blowers, and I can tell you either one of them's a kick in the butt. But Shane, I thank you for coming in today and taking us to school on this a little bit. Man, you helped me make my decision.
Good. Let's get one on that Chevelle.
Okay.